You see, after Jesus died and rose again and ascended to heaven, his disciples didn't just hang out. They had a mission. In Acts 17:6, it says they flipped the world upside down. Every one of you, no matter what your background is, and no matter who your parents are, every one of you has to individuate what you believe. You have to own your faith. And that especially happens when you get to college.
My first time was great. I'm hoping to show up a little earlier next time just so I can be in the mosh pit with everyone. One thing that stood out is living out your faith. I don't want to be one person in front of one group of people and then a totally different whenever I'm at church or in front of a different group. I just want to be the same Jackson all day, every day, no matter who I'm with. So that's what resonated the most with me.
So here's the deal, class of 2025. Owning your faith isn't just about what God wants to do in you, it's about what he wants to do through you.
One thing I learned from the sermon, in simple terms, is to be a thermostat and don't let life and, you know, the college life control you. Or don't let other things distract you from what God wants you to do. I really enjoyed the service for my first time, and I'll definitely be back.
I absolutely loved it. I was really looking for something that was close to ASU, that nurtured college students and was still fun, but something I would get messages out of.
The Bible says the same Spirit who raised Jesus from the dead lives inside of us. So Hope Church, we should be the most engaging, most fun-loving, and most creative people on campus, right?
It was my first time and I had a great time. The praise pit was probably my favorite part. I went to a church back in Dallas, where I'm from, and it reminded me of that. And so I loved coming here and I will definitely be back. And so I had a great time.
Listen, Jesus came into a world full of darkness and brought light. A world full of sin, he brought righteousness. A world full of lies, and he was the way and the truth and the light. Jesus changed the atmosphere.